Hello guys, it's your favorite lifestyle blogger, Niger Canada girl. I talk about my experiences as a new immigrant in Nigeria, and I hope you subscribe. If you haven't, now would be a good time to hit the subscribe button. So today I'm going to be talking about a topic so many people have asked me to talk about. I get a lot of comments, DMs, PMs about how to get a house in Canada, especially as a new immigrant, which is what I'll be talking about today. So for this topic, I've had to do a lot of research to also get opinions of some of my friends who have settled, especially the ones who settled really fast after they got in here, you know. So I'll be sharing all those experiences with you. So first of all, let me just give you a brief intro about housing in Canada. Of course, when you come here, the first thing you want to do is get a house. And there are about four types of houses here. There might be more, but the four most popular types of houses are condos, townhouses, apartments, or basements. What are condos? So these are the high rises, tall buildings, beautiful, look like hotels. A lot of them have swimming pools, they have gyms. So let's just say it's like a luxury type apartment where you get to share with other people. Most of them are really tall. A lot of the time they are about 15 floors or more. So if you live in a condo, you'd be sharing things like there'll be a shared laundry room, there might be a swimming pool, a gym. It really depends on how luxurious the condo is. And there's just something about condos, they're actually really beautiful. So it's no surprise a lot of people would actually want to live in condos, condominiums, I think that's the full name. And then we have townhouses. A typical townhouse is just like what we have in Nigeria. So if you live in a duplex and we had the equivalent here, it would be called a townhouse. So that's just like a proper house. It's called townhouse. And then apartments. So apartments are like the less luxurious versions of condos. So apartments could come in different forms. They could come as high rises. They could come just like townhouses. So basically, it's just an apartment, you know. It has, it could have two rooms, it could have three rooms, but it might not have all those perks a condo might have, like a central swimming pool, a gym, and all those facilities to just make it look like you're living the vida loca, yeah? So, and then for basements, so basements is one of, basements are one of the very popular types of houses we have here, especially for people who first get into Canada. The first thing a lot of them tend to tilt towards is basements. One is that basements are cheaper, and a basement basically is just like the name implies, it's the basement level of a main house. So a lot of houses here in Canada are built with basements, and a landlord can decide to, you know, just give his basement out or rent it. A lot of landlords here actually make money off renting their basements, and a lot of them rent them from about $500 upwards, $500 being the minimum. That would be a very good deal if you got a basement for $500 per month. So yes, rent in Canada here is monthly. So how then can you get one of these sort of apartments here in Canada? There are two popular ways people get apartments here. There is a website called Kijiji. Yeah, Kijiji. So Kijiji is an online website. They're just like OLX or Gigi if you're Nigerian and you're familiar with this site. So they sell everything, you know, and housing is one of the things they sell and rent. But the thing about Kijiji here is that it is very legit. So if you go to Kijiji, you're able to search based on your location, your price, the sort of house you want. Is it a one bedroom? Is it a two bedroom? And then when you found your preference, you can actually fill a contact form right there or call the landlord. And for each house that is put up on Kijiji, a landlord, every landlord has requirements. So what are requirements? Requirements are things the landlord would you know, demand from you or demand to see at least before he gives his house out to you. And basically what he's trying to do is just to make sure you're credible, you're trustworthy, you're not a criminal, you're able to pay every month, and that when your rent is due, you won't come with stories about not having a job. So some of these requirements are things like employment letter. And some of them actually go check out your employers and see if you actually work there. They need to know that you're employed. Things like pay stubs, they need to see maybe your paychecks for the last 2 or 3 months. They might need something like that. They need a reference or a guarantor. So those are people who have lived here, who are all settled here and can actually vouch for you. So they know who to go to if anything goes wrong. And what else do they need? They also need a credit score. So what are credit scores? So as an immigrant living, as a citizen, immigrant, anyone who lives in Canada, credit score is everything. You get better deals on car insurance if you have a good credit score. You're able to rent houses faster if you have a good credit score. Even sometimes employers would employ you because you have a good credit score. So I'm going to dedicate another video where I talk about credit score, but let me just roughly tell you what it is. So a credit score is just to show that you're credit worthy. If for instance a bank gives you a credit limit of say $2,000, they need to know that for every time you're taking a, you're giving that credit, you're using and paying back as a wind you. So it's just something that shows that you know you are responsible in some way. And there are so many things that could affect your credit score. Okay, so we'll talk about that in another video. So yes, so those things I listed are some of the things landlords might require from you before they rent their apartments to you. But here exactly is the problem a lot of people have. So I'm a new immigrant. I just got here. I am not employed, but I need a house. I do not have an employment letter to show you. I do not have any pay stubs from employer because I'm not employed. I don't even have a credit score yet because, I mean, I just got here. It's going to take a while to build a credit score. So what exactly do I do? So I'll talk about that in a bit. So yes, I've talked about Kijiji being one of the options. Another option is renting a house through agents. So there are agents, house agents, who actually take you around. They always have, depending on your price range, your location, they always have a couple of places they could take you around to check out. And then when you finally pick one you want, you can now discuss with the landlord. Some of them even have extended services like helping you furnish your house, okay? So the advantage of using an agent is a lot of the time you might not have the time to go place to place. You might not even know the right places to go to. So an agent is able to show you the places. They already have a list of possible places that suit your description or that suit your preferences, okay? So sometimes people just get an agent, you know. So you can either try through Kijiji or use an agent. But I'll tell you that from the research I conducted amongst many of my friends, about 80% of people use Kijiji. So really it's DIY. Go to Kijiji, find the house you want, contact the landlord, find out his requirements and if you have it. So from what I discussed with a lot of my friends, the roadblock is actually having some of these requirements the landlord asks for. Like I was saying, you're new in the country, you really don't have these things, you're yet to gather them, you're yet to get a job and all that. So what do you do? Like one of my friends said, the key is keep trying. So for all the people I talked to, the landlords had different requirements, okay? So I spoke with someone who said the landlord just wanted a bank statement. He wanted her LinkedIn profile, and he was good to go with her bank statement from Nigeria, okay? So sometimes that might be an option, although she also had to pay for 8 months. So here, many contracts with house landlords are 1 year leases. It doesn't mean you have to pay 1 year rent. It just means you need to sign a contract that you'd be leasing the house for at least 1 year. So they require you to pay first and last month. So that's 2 months. So if the house, for instance, is $700, you're probably going to be required to pay $1,400 for first and last month. Okay. Sometimes this is all inclusive. All inclusive means your hydro is our electricity bill, so your hydro, your parking, water and all of that might be all included in this bill. Some other times there's a different charge for it, okay? So whatever you do when you're on Kijiji or wherever, just make sure you read all the, because whether it's included or not, they tell you what that bill covers and they'll let you know if you have any extra thing you'll be paying monthly, okay? So just make sure you read the description properly. So yeah, so she was able to get a house without an employment letter. She was able to get a house with her Nigerian bank statement. So like I said, different strokes for different folks. But she had to pay 8 months advance. So what she was trying to get was a townhouse. So her explanation is maybe townhouses are more difficult to get because she had to pay 8 months upfront. And another person I spoke to said all the landlord needed was employment letter and credit score. So he happens to have stayed in Canada for a while, so he has a job and he's been able to gather a credit score, and then he was able to pay, and there was a high demand on the house, so he was able, instead of the first and last month, he paid an extra month, so he was able to pay for 3 months upfront for the house. okay? And the one you are probably most interested in, about 50% of the people I spoke to don't have jobs yet. Well, some of them recently got jobs, but they got these houses even before they got jobs. You know, they said it's just a case of keep trying till you find one. They were able to find landlords on Kijiji who did not require any of these documents. Yes, none at all. No credit history, no employment letter, no reference. Some just need references, you know. So the key is to keep trying. Once you see a house that suits what you want, just keep trying. Keep trying, keep trying, keep trying. You might see a landlord who, you know, it might just be a gut feeling. He meets you and likes you and he's like, okay, fine, you can rent the house. I know you don't have any of these. And, you know, you can also try to be convincing. If it makes them feel any better, to show them your Nigerian bank statement or your LinkedIn profile just to show that you're a credible person, you could also offer that. Okay, so there's no hard and fast route to getting a house in Canada apart from the two broad ways, which is through Kijiji or using an agent, or sometimes it's just referral. You might have a friend who's leaving a house and could say, oh, I'm leaving a house and I know you're interested in getting one, you might want to come see my landlord so you could start staying here after I leave, you know. Another thing is there are people who look for people to share apartments with them. So that's another way to save cost here on apartments. If you want to rent a one bedroom, say you're a single person and you're looking for a one bedroom, that might be actually a bit expensive for you compared to renting a two bedroom. For instance, a one bedroom could be between 800 to 1000 or 800 to 1500 depending on the area. But for a two bedroom, it might be from 1400 to 2000 or from 1400 to 1800. So what that means is if you're sharing a two bedroom with someone, you split the bill and it's still pretty much fair, okay? And also a lot of two bedrooms give you much more space to move around and, you know, do stuff. So that's something you might want to consider. If you already have a friend, you might want to consider sharing an apartment with them. Or even if the person is not your friend, you just know the person a bit and you feel you can live with this person, you can share a two bedroom with the person. If you're looking for a townhouse, a two bedroom, a one bedroom, whatever it is your preference, you can tell an agent or check on Kijiji, okay? So this basically is how to get a house here in Canada. But of course, when you land, one thing that is very important is you don't have a house, so you have to either land at a friend, a relative, or someone who is able to accommodate you, or if you're able to afford an Airbnb, a lot of people opt for this option. So they land in an Airbnb, go online, rent an apartment, put the price range you're looking for. You can make it very minimal since it's a temporary stay. Get an Airbnb, stay there for about a month while you're intensively looking for a house to stay in, okay? So this phase will pass. It's just a phase we all have to go through as newcomers. So when you land at a friend's, a family's, an Airbnb, and start trying out Kijiji and agents as well, okay? So I hope this has been helpful. I have some contact details of some agents you might want to reach out to, but I don't think they would want me putting out their information out there. So what we can do is, if you're not following me on Instagram, you can follow me at Niger Canada Girl on Instagram and send me a DM, slide into my DM, and I'll share some of these agents with you. And remember, I live in the GTA, so this is my experience from the GTA. As a matter of fact, I have another friend who tried the GTA for so long. He's not employed yet, but he wasn't successfully able to get the sort of place he wanted at the sort of price he wanted. And he decided to explore another province. He went to Calgary, and all he did was contact an agent on Kijiji, and he was able to get a place in 10 minutes. Like, it was just a call. Not an agent, a landlord. So the landlord, she didn't ask him for credit score, employment letter, nothing. It was just a phone call. And he went to see the place, he liked it, and he paid. And that was it. So there are no hard and fast rules. Always make sure you check with people, get opinions from other people, reach out to landlords, explain your situation to them, and you just might find someone who'll be willing to rent a place to you without all these requirements. I hope this has been helpful. It's Niger Canada Girl sharing my experiences as an immigrant here. Like I said, I'm going to make a video to elaborate more about credit score and why it's very important to you as an immigrant or even a resident here in Canada. So please hit the subscribe button if you're yet to, share this video with your friends who might be in the process as well or contemplating moving to Canada. Tell them to subscribe as well. So till my next video, have an amazing time. Bye.